Hello, folks. Thanks for joining us. This is Record. Take two. That's why I hate the passive system. Hi, folks. It's Rick Corvette Conti, and welcome to my Corvette vlog. Too often, I don't want to talk about, you know, just the selling part of what I do for a living here on the vlog, but I think at this time of the year in the fall, I think we need to focus on it just a little bit more than we have. There's some great opportunities that come in with used cars. There's some crazy opportunities as we close out the year trying to get allocation in line with new cars. And I really just don't want you guys to miss out on that opportunity. So right now, what we're going to do today is we're going to film on my GoPro Hero 5. I usually don't use this too often. A couple little cut-in pieces you saw. You know, some of the other guys that have come in with an interview and we filmed and drove in the car. That's cool. The GoPro comes in handy, but I've not used it entirely because there's always a mic problem with the GoPro. But what I did, instead of hooking up a little mic and then using a lavalier mic type of thing, is what I did is right on top, I actually drilled a hole in the casing that's holding the GoPro, and then that's right above where the mic port is. So hopefully it's sounding just a little bit better for you today. Usually I use a Canon camera for the vlog, and as you've heard me mention, it's a little bit bigger vlog camera than a lot of folks use. A lot of folks like to use the GoPro. I like to use this Canon camera. I love how the screen kind of flips around. I can add some stuff on the top of some of the different ports. That comes in pretty handy for me. I hold it with that little tripod that's real flexible, so I enjoy that a lot. There's a couple slots there for two SD cards, so I enjoy that Canon camera. I'm comfortable with it. I think it does a nice job for what we're trying to put out here on YouTube for you guys, so I'm going to continue using it. But today we're using the GoPro because, as I said, we want to talk a little bit about some used cars that come in, and they come in and go out so quickly this time of the year. You've got to move that inventory quickly. Now, you folks that are watching me in Arizona and California, Texas and Georgia, like, what are you talking about, man? Yeah, well, our market changes. We'll talk about that just a little bit. But I just took in this beautiful 2006 Le Mans Blue convertible. 2006 Le Mans Blue, 2017 Le Mans Blue. Now, we're in the shade, so I'm not quite sure how it's picking up on the GoPro, but I do like the GoPro because the quality of the recording is phenomenal as far as what you're viewing. I enjoy that a lot. So again, today on the vlog, if you've got a minute and you're eating a muffin, drinking some coffee, whatever it is you're doing, just don't be driving. Thanks for joining us. We're gonna go for a drive and show you and just talk a little bit about this 2006 Le Mans Blue convertible. Quick drive in this 2006 trade-in. It's manual, so thank goodness for the windshield mount of the GoPro. Just so we can, you know, I've talked about it before in other vlogs, where you don't forget of the values that are right in front of you. My goodness, this market is moving so fast. Some of you even commented on my recent videos. They said, man, I can't even believe we're talking about the C8 generation. I mean, it's freaking crazy. It is crazy. It feels like the Stingray just came out, and it's like, you know, bah, 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 here we go, and now we're talking about C8. It's closer than you guys think. And yeah, the 8th generation of Corvette's coming. That's the exciting thing for me, is as much as a hiccup as this year's been for the marketplace with, you know, people kind of waiting for this, waiting for that. I hate the wait type of thing. But with the expansion of the Corvette assembly plant, it gives me good confidence that we've got a bright future ahead of us for Corvette. And all kinds of crazy things are coming. Just waiting for some traffic here so I can get out. But I've not really driven a C6 in a while. This is a really nice trade-in. You know, I thought, you know what? This would be good for the vlog, good for us just to have a little conversation. Me get out and do just a quick little drive. Oh yeah, you can hear that exhaust. I forget what he put on there. I'll have to ask Greg what he put on there, but it's loud and proud, baby. Oh my gosh. And I thought, you know what? This is time for, again, a different type of vlog as we're going in the out of proverbial Corvette season. But for me, thankfully, for a lot of you folks that are in different parts of the country, I stay busy all year long. I mean, I'm really not busy around New Year's Day and that. I think everybody's in that. Other than that, it's every day. It's text, email, calls, people coming in, asking questions. Want to buy something today? Want to buy something next month? Want to buy something next year? So that's good, you know, and it's all around this car, regardless if it's new, regardless if it's used. It's exciting to have those conversations with you folks. GM, you compare the two generations. What I really like that they did in the C6 with the gray interior versus the C7 gray interior, this has black carpeting. I just think from a maintenance level, it's a lot easier. I think aesthetically, it goes great. It's a nice flow of the breakup of the gray and the black with the dash and the cut in the top of the door panels. I think that's just a really nice look on this car, and I wish we had that, because the gray interior on C7 is gray carpeting and so forth. So I encourage my customers to, hey, buy an extra set of mats, buy the black floor mats, ties in nicely to your interior. It's a little bit easier to maintain as well. I don't have the GoPro flip this. Some guy just literally, I'm doing 55, he pulls out in front of me to turn right immediately 100 feet up the road, and there's nobody behind me. So do you think he could have just waited an extra second? No. Oh my gosh, I'm telling you what, Many of you adults need to go back to driving school to understand how to really drive. And many of you, when they take the boys to school in the morning, it's amazing to me how many stupid people are out there that don't know how to use a four-way stop. Hey, morons, it's whoever gets there first, he goes next. Oh, he got here, then he goes. And this guy, I don't know who goes next. Then go home. The neat thing for me too is, and what I try to instill on this channel, so you know you're dealing with not only an enthusiast about Corvette, you're dealing with a retailer that you can trust. So when I say I'm going to do something, I'm going to do something. And when I say I hold a car for you, I hold a car for you. And we've been burnt many a times, but I think that there's some value in you guys buying from us online, out of state, even a couple hours away. Having that trust factor makes a big, big difference. You know, I'll give you an instance. I had a great conversation with a guy that seemed to be, at that level, had the wherewithal to buy a $112,000 car. We make an agreement on the deal. Gonna get these, it was a Z07 car, and then we're gonna get the regular tires installed for it and all that kind of stuff, and he's gonna go do this, and he'll be back in a week. Fantastic. So in the week that he's gone, I get the tires like I say I'm gonna do, get them installed, have it all ready to go. I've had three inquiries and people wanted to buy that car. Made a commitment with this guy, didn't take any money down, good professional conversation, gentleman's agreement type of thing, the way that you used to do business with a handshake. So about a week and a half goes by, a couple weeks go by, I don't hear from this guy. The guy still never contacted us. Think about this, if I had sold the car to one of the three people that inquired about it, even though he and I made an agreement, and he didn't put any money down or didn't sign anything, which sometimes that doesn't matter to some folks, but it does with us. You know, and he came in to get the car and said, hey, did you get the tires installed? I'm here to pick up my car. Oh no, we sold it to this guy that came in after you, after our conversation, after our agreement. You know, what kind of conversation would that be? I'd be the a-hole dealer, all kinds of negative posts on Facebook, blah, 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 but, oh, I wish I had the GoPro turned around right now. Corvette Club, there's got to be 20 vets that just went by right now. Oh, my gosh. Oh, I forgot it's the first Saturday of the month and the Corvette Club comes in for the meeting. Oh, I missed that. Yeah. Yeah, I'm in a vet, so I'm waving. Yeah, man. That's great. But anyway, so what would happen if I sold a car? Didn't do what I say I'm going to do, you know? So... talk to you in a second. My favorite part, getting on the freeway. Oh yeah, baby. Hang on. I've got so much filmed on the GoPro that I've not transferred it yet. I actually filled up the memory card. So that gives you an indication on a 64 gig of how much I've filled in. And then I realize I'm driving and I'm getting on the freeway and I don't have a dealer plate on the car that I'm driving. I'm like, oh my gosh. Hey, I've got a new memory card in my GoPro. We're gonna go for hours in this vlog. No, we're not. Go back in time a little bit for those of you that don't remember or were never a part of Corvette or even thinking about Corvette at that time. Go back to the transition from C5 generation to C6, which we're in now. And this would have been the second year of the C6 Corvette. And he got rid of that big butt on the end that the C5 had. This car is sleeker, it's sexier, it is more refined. Just feels so good. I mean, that steering wheel, you hear a lot of the race guys, they love the point and shoot. Where you steer the car goes, it just gives you total confidence and total control when you have a car that handles like that. So you're not all over the road and wishy-washy and feel like you're driving a semi-truck or what have you. Seats are so comfortable too. And if you remember, these are the old seats that have the heated seats in them that have the coil system. So yeah, those suckers get hot. They get real hot. My butt's on fire! But even in the C5, for the manual transmissions, that had such a long throw. It really did. This is shortened up in C6. The way the shifter's contoured, it just fits your hand just right, and you feel comfortable sitting there, holding onto the shifter, going through the gears. What an enjoyable drive this is with you guys this morning. Thanks for joining us on the vlog. Their annual show. Be the first time for me out there. Be the first time for me on the East Coast, believe it or not. As much as I've traveled, I've never really been on the East Coast. I mean, I've been to Charlotte and stuff, but not, you know, Northeast. I've just never been there. So it's going to be a win for me. I'm hoping that Ryan is able to get out of school and he's able to go with me, and we'll share him on the vlog. Maybe we'll get him to talk on the vlog now that basketball season's starting.
James drives hard and throws it down.
That's what I can get him to talk about. You want to talk about Cavs? That kid will talk your ear off. Don't even challenge him on stats and players. He knows the players' shoe size, how tall they are, what their average points are. I said, hey, take that mindset, man. Make sure you keep your grades up. And he does. Does a great job. All A's and B's, and I'm real proud of him for that. And it's pretty neat to hear him talk about the Cavs, because I learn stuff when I listen to him. I'd rather listen to him talk about the Cavs than ESPN. It's pretty cool. So maybe we can get him to open up and share a little of that with us on the vlog. All right, I'm just sitting here. I'm not driving. That's why I'm not wearing my seatbelt. But just want to thank you for taking a moment out of your day, your afternoon, your evening, whatever the case may be, and you joined us here in the vlog. I hope you enjoyed just some of the brief conversation we had, talking about this car, talking about the market, as we always kind of break off just a little bit and share that with you. And I think that's important for this channel, is to kind of keep it real and keep it from the heart, from a guy that cares and is equally Not equally. I'm probably more passionate about this car than you are. But I get it. You guys get it, and I get it. But I do appreciate you taking the time to watch today and kind of reminisce a little bit about the great value of the C6, this 2006, that we took on a drive today on the vlog. Thank you so much. Hey, now don't forget, at the end of this video, there's going to be that little end slide now that I put up for you, and there's a quick, easy subscribe link so you can join us on the Corvette vlog all the time and you don't miss a thing. I'm so glad that you're here. And remember, if you're going to stop dreaming and start driving, well, I want to be your guy. I want to earn your business, and I want to be a part of your Corvette family. Thanks again for watching, folks.